Greetings from Mission Control Houston, and welcome to this Friday edition of International Space Station Update. Joining us here inside of the International Space Station Flight Control Room at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, where the Orbit 2 team is currently on console monitoring all of these systems on board this orbiting laboratory. Team being led right now by Flight Director Chris Edlin. He's joined at the Capcom position right now by Lucia McCullough, serving as the communication link between all of the controllers down here on the ground and the astronauts up in space. Those astronauts right now are the crew of Expedition 32, currently comprised of a six-person team being led by Russian cosmonaut Gennady Padalka there on the right side in the front row. Behind him are his Soyuz TMA-04M crewmates, Joe Akava over his off to the left, and then Russian cosmonaut Sergei Revin all the way on the right. Then on the left side, we have our three newest crew members on board the International Space Station. Starting on the left, Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide on his second flight to space. Right there in the middle, Yuri Malenchenko, a veteran astronaut on his fifth flight. And then finally, NASA astronaut Sunny Williams on her second flight, second long-duration mission. It's been a very busy week on board the International Space Station with a lot of robotics activity and maintenance work and a slew of preparation work for the spacewalk undertaken by NASA astronauts Sunny Williams and Aki Hoshide yesterday. Starting off on Monday, we had Joe Akava working with Robonaut inside of the Destiny Laboratory. He was working to set up the humanoid robot as it was then commanded from controllers down here on the ground. Robonaut continuing to go through a number of different checkouts and exercises as they look to improve his dexterity and then functions on board the station, eventually becoming a permanent addition to many of the crew activities, taking over some of the more menial tasks like cleaning and taking air readings from these crew members. Aside from that Robonaut work on Monday, Joe Akaba was working to transfer some cargo from the Japanese HTV vehicle, one of the numerous unmanned cargo crafts currently docked to the International Space Station. Meanwhile, his fellow NASA astronaut Sunny Williams is doing a checkout on her SAFER devices. SAFER standing for the Simplified Aid for EVA Rescue. It's a small self-contained, basically a jetpack that these astronauts wear whenever they're outside the station airlocks doing spacewalks, and serves as kind of a safety net device. Should they become untethered and start to float away, they can always fire that jetpack and get back to the safe portion of the space station. She's also going over some of the procedures for her spacewalk, which again took place yesterday on Thursday. Aside from that, she was doing a biomedical experiment working with the station's SLAM device, which stands for the Space Linear Acceleration Mass Measurement Device. Doing a control run, this is one of the only devices on board the station that is able to measure a crew member's mass, given that they are in that microgravity environment. Something like a scale is not very useful. So SLAMMED, again, part of the ongoing research to constantly monitor crew members' bodies throughout these microgravity flights. Aki Hoshide was checking out his own SAFER device on Monday and also going through a procedure review with Sunny Williams, and also transferring some cargo over from that Japanese HTV vehicle along with Joe Akaba. Meanwhile, our Russian cosmonauts on board on Monday, Gennady Padalka, the Expedition 32 commander, was doing a study of the veins in his lower limbs and also doing some replacement work on the Russian Electron system. It's one of the oxygen generation systems on board the International Space Station. Meanwhile, cosmonaut Sergei Revin was unloading some items from the 48 Progress vehicle, which is the unmanned Russian cargo craft currently docked to the International Space Station. You can see the full station complex and all the visiting vehicles right now. Two Soyuz crew crafts, and then three unmanned robotic cargo crafts. The HTV-3 all the way on the left there, the Japanese vehicle, the Progress 48, the Russian vehicle there in the middle, and all the way at the aft end of the station, the ATV-3 vehicle built by the European Space Agency. So Revin was unloading some items from that 48 Progress and also updating the station's inventory management system. Also working on the Russian Pneumo Card experiment, which is a study that looks to track the adaptation of the cardiovascular system inside of these crew members during their long-duration microgravity exposure. And meanwhile, Yuri Malenchenko was transferring a few items and also draining the urine processor assembly recycled tank, transferring some of that wastewater over to the ATV vehicle. Moving on to Tuesday, Joe Acaba was back in the Destiny laboratory powering up Robonaut and then stowing him away following the completion of 2 days of robotic ops down here on the ground. He was also installing a contingency jumper. A number of jumpers were installed prior to this spacewalk, which was looking to replace a failed MBSU power relay system. So this procedure that Acaba took on Tuesday was to supply power to various loads along the station's external truss in the event of a loss of power. So moving on, Williams, Sonny Williams was completing a pre-spacewalk medical exam on Tuesday, and also doing an exploration design challenge, looking to highlight radiation research being conducted on board the International Space Station. She was joined in that by Aki Hoshide, who was also doing his own pre-spacewalk medical exam, and also going through and doing some final procedure updates for all of their EVA tasks. Meanwhile, on Tuesday, Gennady Padalka was doing another medical experiment looking to study orthostatic stability in these astronauts, which has some direct implications in looking at how well these astronauts are able to stand upright and how their balance is affected after spending long durations in the weightless environment. Padalka was also doing some routine replacement of a few components inside of the Russian toilet system. Sergey Revin also joining Padalka in that orthostatic stability evaluation, doing an on-orbit hearing test, while Yuri Malenchenko was replacing a relay adapter inside of the Zarya module, and then standing by with Joe Acaba to review some of those robotic procedures as Acaba was quarterbacking the spacewalk on Thursday and controlling the station's robotic arm. Wednesday was a half-duty day for the crew. Joe Acaba doing some final review of those EVA procedures and then installing another jumper cable. So again, just in case power was lost to any of these from a failed MBSU install, they would still be able to maintain power to vital station systems. Meanwhile, again, in that half-duty day, Sonny Williams was preparing the equipment lock and configuring all of the tools that she and Aki would need for their spacewalk. Aki, meanwhile, was holding one last procedure review in a conference with the ground. You can see them inside of the Quest airlock here, getting everything ready before they were going to step out the following morning. Also on Wednesday, Gennady Padalka was replacing a battery unit inside of the Zvezda service module, while Sergey Revin was inside Zvezda and Zarya collecting a number of air samples, and Yuri Malenchenko doing an audit of the station medical kits and doing his own runs of the pneumocard medical experiment. Moving on to Thursday, yesterday, all eyes were on spacewalkers Sonny Williams and Aki Hoshide as they conducted an 8-hour and 17-minute spacewalk, moving themselves into the history books as it was the third longest spacewalk in history. Their main task of replacing a main bus switching unit on the S0 truss was unsuccessful due to a troublesome bolt. So meanwhile, teams are now looking at coming up with ways to decide the next course of action and then do a potential follow-up of this spacewalk in the nearby future to complete the task, perhaps even as early as next week. And then today, a lot of that post-EVA work going on, Joe Acaba initiating a charge on a number of the batteries that are used for these spacewalks, also getting inside the suits and doing some relief valve cycling, preparing them, again, should they be needed for a spacewalk early next week for Williams and Hoshide. Meanwhile, the two spacewalkers doing some health status checks post-spacewalk. Williams was also working to prepare the suits and photographing the gloves and checking for any damage that may have occurred on the hands while those astronauts are moving outside of the station. She was also going through an EVA debrief with teams here on the ground, along with Joe Acaba and Aki Hoshide. Hoshide assisting in all of that post-EVA prep work, and also having a few more tasks on board the station, relocating some of the contingency water containers, also taking some time out to do a ham radio pass with some students in Mayen, Germany. And then our three Russian cosmonauts today on board the station, Padalka back at Pneumokar doing his own runs, again looking to study cardiovascular adaptation of these astronauts during long-duration space flights, and also replacing a gas-liquid mixture filter. His two fellow Russian cosmonauts, Sergei Revin and Yuri Malenchenko, are giving the TVIS, or the treadmill with vibration and isolation stabilization, its six-month maintenance today. Doing things like verifying the torque on different fasteners and also lubricating a number of the components. You can see the TVIS here. It's one of the many workout devices that these astronauts have while they're on board the station to maintain things like muscle mass and also fight off losses in bone density. So, as you can see, very busy week on board the station with that spacewalk being the centerpiece of all of this week's activities. Teams down here on the ground continuing to look at just what went wrong with getting that main bus switching unit reinstalled, continuing to look at go-ahead options for a potential spacewalk as early as next week.